One of the things that happens when you do start to get more successful, and I think from my experience, and I can only come from my experience, a lot of eyes will come on you. You'll achieve, you'll get all the accolades and all of the criticism starts to happen, right? So, and I think we've all been at the butt end of that in some way, shape, or form. Right now, all eyes are on you guys. And there's always an ebb and flow to all of this. What is it in your mindset that's just keeping you in humility during this time?
You said the criticism, you know, we hear it all the time, or we did hear it all the time. I think for so long, the fans watched our matches and we were a heel's heel. And we wanted to make our baby faces look so good. I don't think the fans consciously knew, oh man, these are the guys that are creating the excitement. These are the guys that are bumping around for this baby face and making them look good. Now it's flipped a little bit. We've, you know, invited them in. They're part of the ride. They were there along the FTR ride. And they see it now. And it's the coolest thing to be able to know that for 35 years, I grew up being a huge professional wrestling fan. So long I admired and looked up and still do to Bret Hart. And now there are fans that come to our meet and greets or tag us online or whatever. And they break down and cry and say, man, you helped me through this, or you guys saved me from this. And the satisfaction I get from that never goes away. Especially after that Renee Young podcast, hearing all the people that said thank you for speaking up because of the struggles I had with anxiety and how it affected my life. Hearing people say you allowed me to understand that I wasn't alone, that just meant the world to me. So being humble is very easy because, man, the fans are fucking incredible, dude.
Yeah, I think after a certain point, you have to try to learn to filter out as much of the criticism as possible. Constructive criticism, I'm all for. At some point, people just want to criticize just to tear you down. I've always been a little bit more antisocial. I can hang out and I can be like, you know, outgoing. But like when my social fuse is done, I withdraw and I need to go decompress and recharge. And so like that, it goes with social media also. I can't read all the stuff on there. I can't acknowledge everything on there. I have to like bring myself away from it and not let it be something that dictates my life or my mood. So for me, I'd made like a choice to try to avoid negativity. Like it just is negative for being the sake of tearing someone down. So again, I think that was something, and Dax and I had to talk about it again, like around the same time as the injury, where we said, let's change mentalities. Let's stop getting frustrated if things aren't going the way we think they should be going, the way we envision them. And let's just start having fun with what we have and make it like control what we can. And once we started having fun and like going that direction, everything just kind of changed and everything just started clicking. I think regardless, like you said, it's ebb and flow, but no matter what, like if people start criticizing us again, that's fine. I'm going to still have fun. I think for the most part, like as long as I'm still having fun and still not letting it affect me and bring me down and affect my work, then the fans are going to enjoy that too. So maybe they'll still enjoy us for a little bit longer and they'll still ride that wave with us.